Ego tiri ae mbuniri wava maiko mudheni mutunga. Mwekwiru wa munene mburagori ya fadha maiko chengwa kanitho wa gatole kitha thaka untiri ya masako. Kiovoke ya miaka mirongo edha tunjera uvuwa kumwedhira na mavetia. Mudheni ya rathi tangito wa muna ekwiru wa engi aere. Na alewa na omara embere ya musiritha ni aruse njogona. Nundo wa kuraga fadha maiko mainge chengwa utuko watare kinyanya mweli wa ikumi. Mwaka wa angiri igiri na ikumi na kenda. Mwenu wa makemaka untiri nini ya mbere ya ngurumo.
Noted the conduct of the accused person immediately after he committed the offense. If he betrayed his innocence by all means, he unjustly enriched himself with the money that he withdrew from the deceased empresa and the bank account, which was done within 3 days. And within the 3 days, he had withdrawn a whopping 400,000. He also took into possession of the deceased motor vehicle and converted it into his own use and continued to drive it as his own without a care. After route, the victim impact report in this case, and I note that he was the family is still very bitter and frustrated, as the deceased was the sole breadwinner and the only healthy member of the family. And I find that the circumstances under which this offense was committed calls for a severe and deterrent sentence. I sentence the first accused person to serve 30 years in prison. And in sentencing the 30 years, I've already taken into account the time that he has spent in custody before he was released on board and when he cancelled his board after he absconded.
Mudheni ule ni wakuruwa miaka mirongo ili netandato nuweriga kwele goti koveto kila wakili wake kile miwantae atene kumana na marakara mauma kwenyamaru wake mwere nefadha chengo na kumugwati ya murimu wa mukingo kwa atumire ya murage ondo musiritha ni aruse njogo na uge teteke voto gosa wa donjarale na kuraga mondo mudheni nonge arumereri ya wadho adhitange fadha ange korono wa nyamari ilwe ke mwere.
So the court has noted that the first accused person is the first offender. I've also considered the mitigation, that he's been merciful and that it's alleged that he acted in anger because that was not proved, and in grief. The accused prayed for mercy from the court, and he has asked the court to impose an unpunitive sentence, and he has also asked the court to be guided by the Morwatetu case. Though the accused asked the court to consider the reason, and I call it the reason in quotes because it was brought up at the mitigation, he thought that it was a good defense, he ought to have proceeded with the case and proved that a revision. So if the accused asked the court to consider the reason in quotes why he committed the offense, and he admitted that he took the law into his own hands, and as a result of that, an innocent life was lost through his heinous crime. There was no justification whatsoever for committing the offense. And even assuming that the deceased was sodomized as he arranged, he ought to have used the legal avenues open to him so that justice could be served, but he decided to take the law into his own hands.
Juliana Mainge, orenengi no afadha Maiko Chengo, vamona Nicholas Mbithika sini afadha, ni mega nila neto liego, tiri ya kukundika mwe kwero mwenene kiovoke ya miaka mirongo edhatu.
Nasema, leo nimevokea kivoti ya zakoti. Inasema, nivatiwe makumu ya mwana wangu, nitolewe ndio leo ndio.
Hii ni kesi ambayo imekaa mahakamani kwa muda na uamuzi wa koti tutakubaliana na uamuzi wa koti, lakini Michael aliacha pengo kubwa sana, na nataka kusema wale wanafuata wanataka tu kuwa na pesa nyingi kupitia njia ambazo hazifai. Ilikuwa pigo kubwa sana kwetu. Ungetoa uhai wa father. Father alikuwa anategemewa na kanisa lake, the congregant wake, na walimpoteza, walikuwa wanampenda. Kwa hivyo, it was very unfair. It was very unfair to kill a very innocent father.
Kuma manyata niembeta kwa muremi. Wagisobi.